Call the Safety and Public Properties meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Meany.
Here.
Mr. Pedicino.
Here.
Mr. Russo.
Here. We need the approval of the minutes of July 13th, 2016.
Okay, I'll go ahead and make a motion to approve the minutes of July 13th, 2016.
Okay, roll call, please.
Mrs. Meany.
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino.
Yes.
Mr. Russo.
Yes. Okay, brings us to item number one, under reports. Jail report, chief, anything you'd like to bring to the committee's attention?
Nothing of significance other than the monthly report you have in front of you.
Any questions from the committee?
No.
Great, thank you. Okay, under police and fire, item number two, we have a memo from Chief Vilen concerning the annual computer equipment update. Chief?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is a revised request that I asked to table at the last agenda. We are asking for replacement of 19 computers for the police department. We were planning on doing that through the state bid system. However, our new IT director did some additional research and found a vendor that was willing to provide exactly the same equipment at less than state bid prices. So I believe attached to your packet as one of these pieces of paper is an affidavit to ensure equivalency of offering, which is required by our finance department.
Right.
So that if we're going to get something at from a vendor at equal to or less than state bid prices, that's their affidavit to guarantee that. That having been said, we're asking, because of the amount involved, for legislation authorizing the purchase of computer equipment at less than the State of Ohio Cooperative Purchasing Program prices from a vendor called MNJ Technologies out of Illinois at a price of $26,842.63. This equipment has already been figured into the current budget appropriations, so we're not asking for additional funding, just authorization to make the purchase. And because of the amount of work that we have been undergoing with regards to the Chagrin Valley regionalization, there's no reason for this to be under emergency. We can make this as a regular purchase.
Any questions from the committee?
What's the warranty on these, Chief?
I believe it's 3 years, Mrs. Meany. That's the general warranty.
Okay.
And Mr. Gibbs and I actually had a discussion today about a refresh program for city IT and hardware, and we try not to let any of our pieces of equipment get too far out of warranty.
Mm-hmm.
We have such a large number, though, that a significant portion of ours are out, and they've been out for a year now, so we're right on the edge. We didn't ask for the full amount this year because we were trying to conserve in the budget appropriations process.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to try and catch up next year with some of those purchases.
And basically, did they find this company through, was it our IT department that found this company, since it?
Mr. Gibbs found this vendor, yes, that's
okay. And he has knowledge of them and their?
Yes, ma'am.
Reputable and all that good stuff.
Okay. Well, and that's the purpose of that affidavit of equivalency, is that
right.
That's their guarantee that they're going to.
That they're going to.
Yes.
Actually give us Dell computers and not some.
Yes, because we've had in the past we've had a situation where somebody, we wanted Dell computers,
mm-hmm.
and we got some off-brand instead,
right.
And we've had issues with those. So okay. This vendor is going to give us exactly what the state bid through Dell would have.
Okay.
And the reason that they're able to do that at a little bit of a reduction in cost is the volume of business that they're doing for Dell as a middleman.
Okay. And I had mentioned 3 years, Chief, but that looks like it's for the monitors, but you believe it's for the Dell computers themselves also?
I believe it's 3 years on everything, yes.
Is there a motion?
Yeah, sure. I'll go ahead and make a motion to have legislation prepared authorizing the purchase of computer equipment through MNJ Technologies for how many computers? 19 Dell computers at a cost of $26,842.63.
Second.
Okay. Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes. Okay, brings us to item number three. We have a memo from Fire Chief Shaw concerning a request to purchase radios. Chief Shaw?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You have the memo indicating the request to replace 12 portable radios for the fire department. This is a unique opportunity in the fact that these units are considered to be used. They were used for approximately 5 to 6 days for the Republican National Convention on a loan agreement to the city of Cleveland. And now they, Motorola desires to liquidate those units at a reduced rate. The fire department had in next year's budget plans to replace 6 of these units and then 6 the following year to try to phase them out. However, after discussing this opportunity with Mr. Rubino, he does believe it is advantageous to act upon this now and replace all 12 radios for half the price.
Is there a question from the committee? Jeff?
Chief, do they, Motorola will, the warranty will be,
yes,
exist,
yes,
for the normal, mm-hmm, period of time?
Right.
Okay.
I just have one question.
Are you getting Nancy?
Yeah, Chief, I mean, when it just says funds will be, funds for this purchase will come from a yet to be determined capital account.
Like, right, so. I spoke with Mr. Rubino. He did not have that information at the time of the memo.
Okay.
He said that he would be able to find the funds out of it. It would be one of the capital accounts, and
okay,
he was going between 491 or 421.
Okay.
Just
okay
had to look and
so
see where it
okay
would fit in. Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Is there a motion?
Make a motion to prepare legislation to purchase 12 used Motorola APX 6000 portable radios for the fire department for the total amount of $30,162. These radios are from the RNC. They come with a lapel microphone, extra battery. We waive the requirements for competitive bidding for the said purchase and declare an emergency because the number of radios are limited.
Is there a second? Okay. Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes. Okay, we have no traffic report for August, so that brings us to engineering item number 5. We have a memo from Mr. Bush concerning the Grant Wood roof replacement. Final closeout, Gary?
The original contract amount for this project was $146,776. We had one change order for replacing all the wood decking that was rotted, and that brought the contract to $156,417.50. As we were doing the closeout for the project, not all the estimated quantities were used. So this final change order and closeout for the project would bring the contract final contract amount to $149,400.50.
Is there any questions from the committee?
I had one, Carrie. On the diagram that shows the final cost and quantity certification form, the one about adjustments associated with the skylight as directed. And the final cost was zero. So didn't they?
Where are you at, Nancy? Which one?
Number 7.
Seven.
I'd have to double check this form. I know we did.
Because they did the skylight, didn't
we
they?
We did replace the skylight.
Yeah, that's what I
that was
okay,
part
that's
of
what kind of threw me. I was like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
I thought, I know there was some issues with them getting it there.
Mm-hmm. There
I mean, that was causing
the,
some of the delay, right? It was just the skylight. But I thought
the
they had done it. But then when
yeah
I saw that the final cost was zero, I thought, oh.
I'll have to double check this form.
Okay. Should we untable this?
I mean, we can probably.
Can we table this, or can we amend it prior to council or at council meeting?
We could amend it prior to council meeting. That way we can just keep it moving, and if there's
okay
an issue, we can pull
okay
it back.
Yeah, so, Carrie, if you could just get, maybe that was just a mistype or whatever,
okay,
so before Monday's council meeting.
Okay.
We appreciate that.
Thanks.
Thank you. Okay, I'll go ahead and make a motion to have legislation prepared to approve the final change order for the Grantwood roof replacement and to close out the contract in the amount of $149,400.50.
What stipulation?
And stipulating that the question that was asked as far as the skylight will be answered before the council meeting on Monday.
Second.
Okay, and there's a second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Fattasino?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes. Okay, brings us to item number six. We have another memo from Mr. Bush concerning the Solon Historical Society change order. Carrie?
This is a change order requesting a time extension for 16 days. The contractor had, their crew had experienced some delays on some other projects and caused the exterior work for this, for our project to be delayed. So they're just asking for this time extension. The original completion date was July 31st, and they're asking for the new completion date for August 16th.
Any questions from the committee? Okay, is there a motion?
This is legislation? Or is just...
Well, I guess we got to approve the change order, right?
Yeah, so we have to do legislation to approve the change order.
Yeah, to approve the change order.
Right. Yeah. Okay, make a motion to approve the change order for ABC Piping Company to move the completion date from July 31st, 2016 to a new completion date of August 16th, 2016.
Second.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes. Okay, brings us to item number seven, status update report from the engineering department. Carrie?
Wanted to give an update on a few items. Aurora Road traffic study, I guess it's going to change its name to the Aurora Road Reconstruction Project. GPD has started the survey work, and that's going to be ongoing for that project. City Hall entrance, we did some survey, or BNN had done some survey last week for this cul-de-sac in the front to do some rework with the pavers and concrete out there. Hunt Club pool demolition, that project has been complete, but we had... That project was needed some extra restoration completed, and then we also had some concrete repairs done in there in that area and had affected the restoration for that project. Police department roof replacement project is underway and is going pretty smoothly. The INET fiber replacement project, that project, if you recall, is extending fiber from our traffic signal system. It extends the fiber from each from the nearest location of the traffic signals to the city buildings, and that'll give us the capability to run our network through the fiber when that's complete. And then City Hall roof replacement. We just had the pre-construction meeting today, and they're working on their submittals, and hopefully construction will be underway soon. Are there any other questions?
Any questions from the committee? Mr. Pedicino?
SOM Center, they say they're signing the contracts. Is there a tentative start date?
The SOM resurfacing? Center resurfacing, it'll be late this month.
Okay.
We haven't had the pre-construction meeting yet, so I don't know the schedule for the project, but and it needs to be complete by November 31st or November 30th.
Well, that's they will, because asphalt, they can't lay at certain temperatures. And I'm assuming the Aurora Road traffic has nothing to do with our signals, but more so with 306 traffic?
I have noticed some increased traffic because of that detour. You know, we had GPD look at some of the signals that just to make sure that they're functioning properly, but there is some heavier traffic through the city with that detour from 306.
Okay.
Nancy, do you have a question?
I do.
I know. That's why I asked.
I did. I'm real quick, Carrie. With the Cannon Road sidewalks, what else was done besides the sidewalks? Was there anything else done in that project besides just putting the sidewalks?
I think they had to relocate an air release valve from Nestle's, or for a force main in the area, but it's just sidewalks.
It was when?
It's just a sidewalk project other than that.
Okay. And then, you know, my favorite subject, speaking of traffic signals, have we gotten the new cameras yet?
We have not. I just got an update email today that said FLIR and CT Technologies is trying to schedule a meeting with the city in September. John and I have communicated with them that before they install those cameras, we want to have an action plan in place of what they've done to fix some of the issues with this refreshing of the cameras during periods of low activity. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we obviously, the new cameras are supposed to fix the heated lens, the heater issues.
Right.
But we are still experiencing some issues with a few intersections where at night the refresh rate is not, it's causing the signals to go into recall and signal constantly. And I know the dual schools and the Mark signal has had the most complaints. So we want to make sure that they are addressing those issues as well before they install those new cameras. We don't want to install all of those new cameras and still have the same issues, so.
Yeah, because I've gotten complaints from people like real early in the morning, like on the weekends. I had one Cannon Road going westbound, and if you want to turn onto Harper to get on the freeway, they tell me they just go through the light. You didn't hear that, Chief, no. You know, because they just, you know, and they say even when they're going on the ramp up to the freeway, they look back and the light is still green on the Harper end and hasn't changed on Cannon.
Well, I wouldn't advise anybody to run a red light.
I know, I tell them that.
And, you know, to obey the signals, they're there for a reason. Obviously, it's annoying to stop at a traffic signal when there's no traffic coming in at the cross street.
But they say this is like minutes that go on. And I don't know if like when they go into this whatever, this quote-unquote sleep mode or whatever happens during the night with them.
It from what I understand, it just puts the signal in recall, which means that it services every phase, whether there's vehicles or not. It just,
okay.
As if there's no detection there, so.
Okay. Does weather like this affect them?
It shouldn't extend the time, it shouldn't
Well, yeah, that's what makes me think something's goofy over there, because it should change at some point. And it isn't just one resident I've heard from, it's more than one.
Yes. I'd make the suggestion that if you have somebody who seems to find a traffic signal that doesn't appear to be functioning correctly, that they call us right away so that we can send somebody.
Okay.
And we will send an officer to actually go visualize the operation of the signal, make sure it's working. That way we can pass that information on to engineering right away.
Okay, thank you. And does weather like this affect it?
It's not supposed to.
Okay.
Is there a time frame that they won't, like last year you said they didn't, like in the winter, they're not going to put these lights up? So, I mean, is it a project that they're going to finish prior to the inclement weather coming in, or?
We hope so. I think they're planning to do the installations in September. I don't want to lock us into a date because they told us that we were going to do the installations in August. So we're working with them. We've been asking them every few days to give us a date. They know that we're anxiously waiting to resolve the issues.
I have to make one other comment. This was a good thing. I don't know if residents know, but Hawthorne Parkway is finally open. I mean, I know that wasn't a city project, but boy, after almost 2+ years of having that closed, it is really nice to finally have that open. And it looks really nice, too.
It does look nice. And I know we've been working with ODOT also on the Brainerd Road Bridge. Their contractor had defaulted.
Right.
So they've been working with the bonding company to get the work resolved.
Okay. I appreciate that. Thank you.
I had one other item to mention on the fire suppression system for the Solon Historical Society. The Fire Prevention Bureau and the Historical Society, the contractor had sent an email saying that they wanted a different fire alarm system other than what was specified. We're trying to work out the details with that, but may bring some change order if there's some cost impacts to the difference.
Wanted the different one? The Historical Society or the Fire Prevention?
I'm not a fire suppression expert, but I guess the fire alarm was a water gong that was specified, and they want to use an electric bell with a strobe light.
But who wants to? The Historical Society?
The Historical Society and the Fire Prevention Bureau.
Okay.
Had suggested that.
Great. Any questions on this?
No.
You sure?
I'm positive. Okay.
Okay, brings us to item number 8. Mr. Pedicino and myself will be out of town for the September meeting, and we were looking to see if we could move that from September 14th to Monday, September 12th. Any issues with that?
Is there a council meeting? No, there's not, right?
No, there's no council meeting that day.
Same time, 6?
Right, same time. Just moving the day. So we will go ahead and move our September safety meeting from September 14th to Monday, September 12th at the same time, 6 p.m. Okay? Anything else? Is there a motion to adjourn?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Jeff seconds. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes. Meeting adjourned.